guys, good evening. It's Friday, November 7th. Out here for the evening hunt. It's about 3:30. I'm just getting set up out here at Kellogg Forest here in Augusta, Michigan. I'm out here with my dad. He's been out here hunting the last couple days. And I'm kind of sitting up on the top of a ridge. A lot of oaks and pines. As I'm walking in, there's a few scrapes down here. My dad's been kind of sitting around, not specifically in this area, but along this ridge. He's had some deer working this ridge. So I'm set up here, just about at the top of the ridge. I got a real nice thicket here to my left. Kind of peaks here to my left, pine trees and thickets. And then out here to the front, I can see the whole side of the ridge. And then down to my right, it flattens out, and the main trail's down there. So I'm only off that main trail probably just about 100 yards. But the idea is, hopefully there's not a ton of people out here walking. There's only one other car out here tonight. It's nice and cold, about 35. Nice southwest wind coming in my face. I got the creek to my right, about 200 yards. So I'm hoping that they either work their way out of that creek bottom, work this ridge, or they're on the other side of this ridge. Tomorrow off from work. I got a long weekend of hunting in front of me, trying to get one down. So we'll see what happens here tonight.
There I was, back in the wild again. And I felt right at home, where I belong. I had that feeling, coming over me again. Just like it happened so many times before. The spirit of the woods is like an old good friend. Makes me feel warm and good inside. And I knew his name, and it was good to see him again. 'Cause in the wind he's still alive. Old friend Ben, walk with me down the trails again. Take me where I belong. Oh, friend Ben, I'm glad to have you at my side, my friend. And I've torn you in the big hunt before too long. Before too long. It was kind of dark, another misty dusk. And it came from a tangle down below. And I tried to remember everything it taught me so well. I had to decide which way to go. Was I alone or in a hunter's dream? The moment of truth was here and now. I
felt his touch, I felt his guiding hand. The buck was mine forevermore.
Hey guys, it's 7:30. And I just put the smack down on a doe at 30 yards. They took a shot and smoked her. I didn't hit it hard enough. Alright guys, well, quick update here. It's 9 o'clock. Since I didn't get to do a interview this morning before I shot that doe, it's Saturday, November 8th. Had that doe come in right at 7:30. And shot her by 7:40. She took off here behind me, back along this ridge, crashing in the trees and stuff. I don't think she went too far.
Because of Fred Bear, I'll walk down these trails again. Take me back where I belong.
It's about 11 o'clock. Took all the stuff back to the trucks. Got my dad here, and we are going to try and track this doe I shot. So we're about
100 yards.
Maybe about 100 yards now where the first blood started. Found the arrow about 80 yards or so. So I think it was a pretty good shot. Might have been a little high at the angle I was at. So maybe that's not why we're not getting a lot of blood. But there's enough blood to follow. So hang tight here and see if we can find a deer.
Fred Bear, I'm glad to have you by my side, my friend. And I'll join you in the big hunt before too long.
Alright, hey there guys, it's 12:30. We are still on the search for the doe. Still got a little bit of blood. Not as much as we did to start. Starting to taper off. And starting to get pretty diluted from the rain that we had after I shot her. The spots of blood that we are finding have been pretty difficult. So unfortunately, that's why it's never good to shoot a deer when it's raining. I mean, it wasn't raining that hard, so I thought we could get away with it, but it's proving to be pretty difficult right now. Well, good morning guys, it's November 9th, it's 8:30 out here at Kellogg Forest again, where I shot that doe yesterday. Unfortunately, we bumped her about 200 yards from the stand at 1:30. We let her sit for 6 hours, and we ended up bumping her out of some thick pine tree brush. She ran over to some private property. We walked into the private property for about 100 yards and scanned it, and we didn't see her. So we ended the search about 2 o'clock. So I decided to sit up in the same spot this morning. And right at 7:25, I had a doe come out of these pine trees in front. fence passed, and then I had a doe way over to my right, probably about 100 yards, working that ridge over there. She ended up going back where we were tracking my doe yesterday. So about 9 o'clock, it's pretty quiet. Haven't seen anything since then. So just keep at it. I'm hunting tonight too. So hopefully we can get something done here. I hate being that close and not being able to get a shot. Man, it's sickening. But I'm going to keep at it. My luck's bound to change at some point, so I got to be ready when it does. So that's hunting. That's why they call it hunting and not killing. So you got to keep your head up. Keep at it. And be ready for the next opportunity. Because you never know when that's going to come. Oh my God. Big buck down. Big buck down, baby. It happened so fast, I couldn't even get it on camera, man. It happened so fast, I couldn't even get it on camera. He was right here, 20 yards. I just saw him crash. He just saw him crash, man. He was on the run. He was on the run. He just crashed in the thicket, man. He's right there. Nice. My biggest buck. My biggest buck. Oh my God. That's what the rut's all about, baby. That's what the rut's all about. Oh my God. He's right there. He didn't even go 50 yards, man. He just flopped in the thick stuff. He just flopped in the thick stuff, man. Nice, nice 8-point, dude. Holy crap. Holy. He's just running this ridge, man. On the run. On the run. 20 yard shot right here, dude. Oh my. I can't believe that just happened. I can't even believe that just happened, dude. Some grunts. I don't know, maybe he heard me. I did some big grunts, man. I bet he heard that grunt. And I did a series of grunts about 5 minutes ago, maybe.
Alright guys, it's 12:30. I got the family out to track and hopefully recover the buck I shot at 9 o'clock this morning. So, got them out to pull them out of the woods and have fun doing that. It's a beautiful morning, so we'll see what happens. All right, guys, so here we are. We just found the arrow. I could see that from my stand earlier, so I know right where it was, which is nice. We're about 40 yards from my tree. Got pretty good penetration halfway down my shaft, and we looking like we got some good blood here. We just found him, guys, right where I saw him crash from the stand. Looks like a beautiful deer, right on or just behind the shoulder. Let's take a look, man. Looking like a brute. My biggest buck. Awesome.
Oh my gosh, he makes me look silly. He took this out.
Here, Dad, will you take this, put the balls down, get behind them. To right over there. It's on.
Right on the shoulder. Blew right
through. What do you think that thing is?
You have blood all over your feet.
There's a mounter. I'm mounting him.
There you go. Finally.
He's got some ass to him. He's been dead since I saw him fall. Pretty good. Right on the shoulder. Blew right through him, man.
Alright, guys. Good afternoon. It's November 9th. We just recovered the 8-point I shot this morning. Beautiful morning. He coming in about 9 o'clock on the run. Didn't give me much time. Unfortunately, I didn't get him on camera. He was just moving too fast, so all I could do was grab my bow. I got him to stop at 15 yards, and then put the shot right on the shoulder, and he ran probably about 80 yards. So he's pretty stiff, so he's pretty much been done since I shot him. So beautiful 8. Smack daddy.
You got our arrows home.